On the TEAS test, you're going to encounter a lot of word problems. Here we have one example of something you might see when taking the TEAS test. It says, if Sara can read 15 pages in 10 minutes, how long will it take her to read 45 pages? Here we have a rate, 15 pages in 10 minutes, which can be written as a ratio or a fraction. 15 pages in 10 minutes. Or you could write it in the reverse, 10 minutes in 15 pages, or 10 minutes to 15 pages. Then we have this third piece of information, 45 pages. And you see that the units there, the pages, match the units or one of the units you have in your first ratio. That needs to be a clue to use a proportion, which is just a ratio that's equal to a ratio. And what's really important about setting up proportions is that you're consistent. So if your first ratio is pages to minutes, then your second ratio should also be pages to minutes, which tells us to put the 45 pages on top of our fraction in our numerator. So what we're trying to find is, how many minutes is it going to take to read those 45 pages? There's more than one way to solve a proportion. One of the easier ways, and it won't always work because the easier ways don't always work, or we wouldn't come up with the harder ways, but one of the easier ways to solve this would be to look at either your numerator or denominator and figure out what you'd have to do to get your other numerator. So, for example, what do you have to do to 15 pages to get 45 pages? Well, 15 times 3 is 45. So you just do the same thing in your denominator. 10 times 3 would be 30 minutes. So it's going to take 30 minutes to read those 45 pages. But like I said, that won't always work. What will always work is using cross products. And that just means cross multiplying. 15 times x is 15x, and that's equal to 10 times 45, which is 450. What you need to know about proportions is that their cross products are always equal. So now you just need to solve your equation, which means undoing what's been done to your variable x. So in this case, we need to divide both sides by 15. And x, again, equals 30. So now we know it's going to take 30 minutes to read those 45 pages. On the TEAS test, you're going to see a lot of word problems. Here's one example of one type of word problem that you might see. Restaurant customers tip their server only 8% for poor service. If their tip was $3.70, how much was their bill? So here we have a percent, the tip or part, that's part of a whole, and then what we're asked to find is the whole. So you can use the percent equation that part is equal to percent times whole to solve this problem. Your part in this case is the tip. The tip they left was $3.70. The percent is this 8%. But we don't do calculations with percents. So you have to either change that percent into a decimal or into a fraction. 8% as a decimal is 8/100. The way you go from a percent to a decimal is just to take the decimal in 8%, which is at the back of the number, and move it two places to the left, and then filling that empty place with a zero. So we, for this percent, we'd put our 8/100. times the whole, and the whole is what we're trying to find, so that's our variable, x. Now to solve for x, you just need to undo multiplying by x by 8/100 by dividing both sides by 8/100. $3.70 divided by 8/100 is $46.25, which means that the bill for their meal was $46.25. So there's one example of a problem that you might see on the TEAS test. On the TEAS test, you're going to see a lot of word problems. Here I have one example of a word problem that you might encounter on the TEAS test. If Leonard bought 2 packs of batteries for X amount of dollars, how many packs of batteries could he purchase for $5 at the same rate? This is a key word right here, rate, because it tells you to set up a ratio or a proportion, actually. So our first rate that we have is 2 packs of batteries for X dollars. We can set that up as 2 packs for X dollars. And then it says at the same rate, which tells us that we're going to set up a proportion. The key with proportions is to be consistent. Looking at our first ratio, we have packs to dollars. So our second ratio should also be packs to dollars. And the information they've given us is the $5, which goes in your denominator with dollars. What we don't know is how many packs of batteries. That's what we're trying to figure out. How many packs of batteries could he purchase? So I'm going to use Y since we've already used X down here. What we have to keep in mind, since we have two different variables, is that we're trying to solve for Y this time, not for X. Notice in our multiple choice answers that they all have that variable X in it. So we're trying to solve for Y this time, not X, which is kind of weird. Just having two variables is kind of weird. Okay, so to solve this proportion, and to solve any proportion, we can use cross products, which just means cross multiply. 2 times 5 is 10, and that's equal to X times Y. Again, we have to remember that we're trying to solve for Y, not for X. X is actually part of our answer. In order to get Y alone, we need to undo multiplying by X by dividing by X. So Y, or the number of packs of batteries that Leonard can buy, is 10 divided by X. So there you have an example of a problem that you may encounter when you take the TEAS test. The TEAS test has a lot of word problems on it. Here's one example of a type of word problem that you could encounter when you take the TEAS test. It says, choose the algebraic expression that best represents the following situation. Gerald's score, J, was 5 points higher than half of Kara's test score, K. I like to say that we're taking English and translating it into math in this case. So if you can figure out what the key words mean, then this is actually pretty simple. So we're just starting with J. This word was is the past tense of is, and is in math means equals. So this word was is an equal sign. And then of course, 5 is 5. Higher than tells you to add. It's just like more than or greater than. And all those words mean to add. Half, of course, means half. Of is another really important word. Of tells you to multiply. So you multiply whatever comes on either side of the word of. So it's half times Kara's test score, K. So it's half K. Another thing with higher than or greater than or more than, it's that word than tells you that actually you need to switch the order. Instead of writing 5 plus half K, you just switch these around. So it says J equals half K plus 5. But really, these say the same thing. Since when you're adding, it doesn't matter the order that you add two things in, you get the same answer. That's the commutative property of addition. So, we see then that A is our answer here. And there you have one example of a type of word problem that you may encounter when you take the TEAS test. You're going to encounter a lot of word problems on the TEAS test. So let me walk you through how to solve one type of word problem you may encounter. Enrique weighs 5 pounds more than twice Brendan's weight. If their total weight is 225 pounds, how much does Enrique weigh? Even though this is a short problem, there are actually two different equations we can write from it. The first one starts with the first sentence. Enrique weighs. This is another way of saying Enrique is. And is in math is an equal sign. Since we don't know Enrique's weight, we'll use a variable. And in this case, an E makes sense. So Enrique is 5 pounds more than, and more than tells us to add, twice Brendan's weight. We also don't know Brendan's weight, so we need another variable, and in this case, a B would make sense. The twice tells us to multiply times 2. So since it's twice Brendan's, this is actually going to be 2 times B. More than, besides telling us to add, also tells us to switch around the order. So instead of writing 5 plus 2B, we would write 2B plus 5. Now, honestly, it doesn't really matter, 5 plus 2B, 2B plus 5. It is the same thing. That's the commutative property of addition. That's the first sentence in our first equation. Our second sentence has our second equation. If their total weight is 225 pounds, how much does Enrique weigh? Total tells you to add. And what are we adding? Enrique and Brendan's weight together. So Enrique's weight plus Brendan's weight is, and again, that is tells us an equal sign, 225. Okay, so how are we supposed to solve these two equations that each have two different variables? Well, you have several options. You could graph both of these equations, which I know nobody wants to do. You could use elimination, but really they're not set up for that. This one is, but this one isn't because the 2b isn't on the same side. Like this equation, you have both variables on the same side of the equal sign, but you don't in this one. So what they're really set up to do is substitution. And since that's the easiest way to solve it, I think that makes the most sense. We're going to use substitution. We're going to take this 2b plus 5 and use it to replace the E in this equation. Since what this says is that E and 2B plus 5 are the same thing, then we can replace the E with this expression 2B plus 5. This equation then becomes 2B plus 5 instead of the E plus B equals 225. Now we're able to actually solve this equation because it only has one variable. Starting with combining your like terms of 2b plus another b, which is a total of 3b's, plus 5 equals 225. Now we need to subtract 5 from both sides. 3b is equal to 220. And then divide both sides by 3. So 220 divided by 3 is not a pretty number. 3 goes into 22 7 times. That'd be 21. 1 left over 10. So it's 73 and actually 3/10 repeating. Or you could say 73 and 1/3. Okay, but going back to the question, they didn't ask us how much Brendan weighed. They asked us how much Enrique weighed. So now that we know Brendan's weight, we can use that to find Enrique's weight by using this equation that already says Enrique. What does he weigh? He weighs twice Brendan's weight, which we just found is 73 and 3/10 repeating, or 73 and 1/3, plus 5. So Enrique weighs 2 times 73 and 1/3 is 146 and 2/3, plus 5. So that is 151 and 2/3, which is closest to the 152 pounds. So there you have an example of a type of word problem that you may encounter when you take the TEAS test.